Hey, it's Dave Wyman from Wyman and Bob. Time for Football 101. Later on the week, we're going to do a little bit. I'm kind of featuring certain players that are really helping in this defense that are doing the little things and sometimes big things like K.J. Wright. But next week, we'll look at a couple of those things from both the Rams game from a couple weeks ago and Arizona. If you remember, at the end of that Rams game, the defense started to get really good, and then the performance on Thursday night was just fantastic. K.J. Wright, to me, you know, there was a lot of talk about him possibly, you know, losing a step in his 10th year and that maybe they shouldn't have him on the team. And there was lots of that kind of chatter. I just thought his leadership and the way he played physically last year, he's continuing that this year. He's so valuable to this team. But right now, 54 tackles, a sack, 6 tackles for loss, you know, interception. And then he has 5 or 6 pass breakups as well. So 2 fumble recoveries. He's just been all over the field. More than anything, though, he just does the little things. And let's take a look at this. And this isn't a little thing. I mean, making an open field tackle on Kyler Murray in your 10th year as a linebacker, it's pretty amazing. So this is a play from the 1:31 left in the second quarter, and they're out here trying to, you know, mount some kind of a drive at the end of the half, and KJ just makes an incredible play here. But what you got here is just a read option, and KJ, we talked to this week, he talked about how, you know, he told the defensive ends, and this was Benson Mayoa, and you know, how you just crash down on the running back, let us take care of Kyler Murray. Well, what happens is, you know, these guys block down here and both of them come down and crash into where what's going to be, looks like a handoff right here. And then he just keeps it and then bounces outside. So KJ comes from, he's lined up all the way inside, almost over the center, comes all the way from here and gets to the outside and just sort of, he does a bunch of things that are really important when you want to make an open field tackle. First of all, inside out. You don't want to go too far over the top. He'll cut back inside of you. So he was sort of stalking his backside shoulder. The other thing, feet always moving. And that's something whenever you make an open field tackle, your feet have to be going. They have to be. Then the other thing is shoulders square. Hips square, and you see all of that from KJ Wright. And Murray tries to put a little move on him and then come back inside. Boom, makes the tackle right there. So KJ Wright, and the theme kind of, you know, later on in the week we'll talk about is guys doing the little things, as I mentioned, but really it's about handling the perimeter. Make sure you take care of the outside, force every play back inside, and that's what KJ does. And so let's take a look at this play on film. Let's look at the first shot here. KJ's lined up even further over to the left, so he has a long way to travel. That's one of the things that makes this thing so such a great feat. I mean, he makes the tackle all the way out here. But here's the look, and they kind of know what's coming here, and you're going to see these guys crash down inside, and KJ just shift sort of laterally over to the top. Here's where the play starts, and you can see KJ's got it diagnosed right away. He's sure what's gonna happen here and knows that these two guys are gonna crash down on the running back. And this is a puller right here. He was lined up at tight end. He's coming across to kind of clean this up. And, you know, this is an interesting, it's difficult to execute this, Kyler Murray, what he's doing, this read option, because a lot of times at the mesh point there can be fumbles and things like that, but he does it really well. And so here we go. We got a guy in his second year right here, and we got a guy in his 10th year right here. In the open field, who do you think's going to win? Now, take a look at KJ. As I mentioned, shoulders square perfectly, hips square perfectly, feet moving. And he's not quite stalking him inside out right here, but it gets in that position later. And actually, you know, he's the force guy. So although you do need to, you know, if you're an inside out guy, like for Bobby, he's more inside out. It looks like KJ's actually the force guy, so he's going to want to turn him back in. So, but it's just a good example of just a very technically sound tackle in the open field with the highest degree of difficulty. Here KJ is up here. You can see both feet are off the ground right there, and he's just very light-footed. Now, that looks bad right there as far as being frozen. You don't want to ever want your feet that close together, but he's just hopping. He's just taking a little hop step to the outside, And here comes the tackle to block him too, and I'm sure he sees him out of the corner of his eye, which is even further distracting. And finally, KJ takes him down for a 2-yard loss. It was just so impressive to see that. And one of the things I said afterwards, it's like, I don't ever want to hear anybody say that KJ Wright has lost a step in his 10th year. We have a great interview of him on Monday, and he's just one of the stalwarts on this defense and so important to this defense in so many ways, because he does the big things like this, but he also does the little things that nobody notices.
Football 101 is brought to you by Heritage Distilling Company, makers of BSB, Brown Sugar Bourbon.